Max Forum stand. And which company do you are you?
I'm working for WaveSat, who is a member of the WiMAX Forum.
Yeah.
And a chipset designer.
So, do you know when it will be possible to have WiMAX in a PDA or in a laptop or?
I would see this happening maybe in about a year time frame. Like today, the equipment available is still too large to allow a integration into a PDA. However, with the progress in the RF world as well as the miniaturization of the chip itself, I would think that within a year you will have it integrated into PDA.
Yeah, but this one that you're showing here looks quite small already. So
it is small, but still a bit too large for a PDA. Don't forget that into a PDA you already have Wi-Fi interface, Bluetooth interface. Yeah. You have a main processor as well, so that all takes space and the screen.
Yeah. So this one it's to receive the signal in a device.
That's right. In fact, receive and transmit. It is what we call a subscriber unit or subscriber station.
Yeah.
So it does communicate to a base station, to an operator. To get broadband wireless access.
All right. So to this one, you connect an antenna, a small antenna somewhere?
Or? That's right. In this case, we have an antenna port, which is that little connector here. And usually it goes onto a mechanical connector to which you connect an antenna, an outside antenna as of today. But in the future, there will be also indoor available.
Indoor? So this is more like outdoor?
So this one is the PCB goes. Yeah. But the antenna itself is normally in a window somewhere. And I would say within the year, you'll also see some units that are totally installed indoor, including the antenna.
Okay, so this one is both mobile and fixed.
This one is fixed only.
Fixed only.
We have a chip that will be coming at the end of the year that will support portable and nomadic application using OFDM 256 FFT.
All right.
And next year, we are coming with another chip that will support full mobility, portability, nomadicity, as well as fixed, and either in OFDM or OFDME.
Right. But why can this one not be mobile? What's the difference?
It's just because the design is not suitable for mobility in the sense that it doesn't provide all the features needed for mobile. It's for sure you could move a little bit with it and still communicate, but it's not designed to support high vehicular speed, I would say.
All right. Ah, okay. But it's compatible with the E standard?
This one is compatible with the IEEE 2016-2004 standard.
Yeah.
The 802.16e standard, which was just out late last year, will have a product available that will cover that standard at the end of this year.
At the end of the year,
yes.
Okay. All right. Thanks. That's it. Thanks.
That was my pleasure.